Rossi's fifth place puts him 25 points clear of Lorenzo.
I was lucky because it was just a small crash. 11 points are like gold for the championship.
Yeah, for sure, he has been a little bit lucky. My bike was completely destroyed. This is not over. There is 7 races to the end. Things can change.
Back on track after the summer break for the race in the Czech Republic, Rossi, Lorenzo and Pedrosa are on the front row. Casey Stoner is in Australia. Under doctor's orders, he's withdrawn from the next 3 races. The MotoGP world is stunned. Casey Stoner is stopping for 2 months because he's tired. Tough guy motorcycle racers don't do that. They race with broken bones. They never give up.
You know, people just don't understand that, you know, when you're not competitive and you're getting worse each race, there's no sense to just keep going. You know, you've got to stop, find the problem and fix it. You know, if a bike isn't running right and you're nowhere near competitive, you have to stop, try and fix it and continue. So it's no different with the human body, and, you know, this is what we needed to do.
The championship is now a straight fight between Rossi and Lorenzo. Rossi makes a great start, but Lorenzo hunts him down. With 6 laps to go, he's on Rossi's tail.
I know that Jorg is very strong. From the pace on the practice, he was also faster than us, but we make a good modify after the warm-up. I have a better feeling with the front of my bike. When you overtake me, I was ready for the battle.
Nine laps to go. Lorenzo's coming. You can hear him. Prepare to strike back.
when I catch him, I tried to open a gap, but I was struggling a lot and was a little bit tired. So I did a mistake in one braking and I crashed. For sure, the championship is almost impossible.
It's adding up. The mistakes, the crashes, the injuries, the pressure, the points. The difference between Lorenzo and Rossi. The difference between ambition and achievement. Pedrosa follows Rossi home. With Lorenzo and Stoner out, there's room for one more on the podium. Andrea Dovizioso or Tony Elias. Who's it gonna be? You haven't been on the podium in a year. You crashed out of the lead in the last race, the British Grand Prix, which Dovizioso won. Dovizioso on the factory Honda, which is that little bit better than your satellite team Honda. It's all good motivation.
Thank you.
today is very tough because Jorge in the practice go with a fantastic rhythm. So I try to make the perfect race, great start, push like a devil, more than 100%. Thanks to Jerry, to my team and to Yama, because today the bike was perfect. We have to stay concentrated, keep pushing because the championship is so long. We have 50 points of advantage, but for sure in 2 weeks in Indianapolis, Lorenzo try another time to arrive in front of us.
Riders, start your engines.
Lorenzo shows up at Indianapolis as Captain America, a show of confidence. He's re-signed with Yamaha for 2010. And he wants the boss's job.
We can win still, but it's a difficult point. Our goal is to enjoy, try to get some podiums and some victories if possible.
Danny Pedrosa is fit, strong, and fastest in every practice session. He makes a flying start. Then he goes a little too fast. Now it's another Yamaha duel. Keep pushing. Pressure, pressure, pressure. It's all on him. You've got nothing to lose. Go for it. Get past him and push.
after Donington and Breno to be here in the first position and to see Vale and Danny crash. Oh, this is fantastic for me and for the team. We'll see what happened. The championship was almost impossible before this race. Now it's difficult, but it's possible.
There are two more places available on the podium. Alex De Angelis is chasing his best result of the year. Meanwhile, national pride is at stake in the fight between Texas Tornado Colin Edwards and Kentucky kid Nicky Hayden on the second Ducati. Nicky Hayden, this is your home race, 3 hours up the road from Owensboro, Kentucky. It's between you and Colin Edwards for the final place on the podium. No way is that Texan going to beat you in your own backyard. Alex De Angelis, fifth on the grid. Can you win today? Maybe not, but you could take second. Valentino Rossi is an ass. This is the champion's opinion of his performance at Indianapolis. And it's given him and his friend, the designer Aldo Drudi, an idea.
After the race, I call Aldo and they say, we lose the 25 points, but we find the right idea for Misano.
There's only one result the people of Rossi's homeland will accept. Their hero will have to fight for it.
I hope to make a better start and try to go in front, but unfortunately, Dani overtake me and also Tony at the first corner. And Jorge also at the end of the first lap. So I was fourth and I was a little bit in trouble with a lot of fuel, not confident at 100%. So I decided to take my rhythm, to put the right temperature on the tires and start to push.
It has to happen. There is no question. You're in Italy at your home track. There are three Spaniards in front of you. You will overtake them. You will win the race. There's no beating Rossi this weekend, and you know it. It's his day. But it's not his championship, not yet. Get past Pedrosa and take second. These are vital points. Keep the fight alive.